My God is strong. He'll do anything, big or small. Nothing is impossible for a super wonderful God. Every day I can know God is always there for me and my family. Every day I can know greater is the one who lives inside.
Love will lead me through. You are the peace. lost, stuck out at sea. The waves grow high, the winds blow strong, in your heart believe. There's a light that's shining, it's never going out. Don't give up now, don't lose hope, the future's looking bright.
Far before us, you're the brightest. You will lead us through the storm. Far before us, you're the brightest. You will lead us through the storm. Far before us, you're the brightest. You will lead us through the storm. Far before us, you're the brightest. You will lead us through the storm. My lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you.
Thank you. Today, we're in the third book of the New Testament, Luke. But before Luke, in the very beginning, out of deep love, God made an amazing world. But when people turned away from God, the world was broken.
God made a plan to draw people back into a relationship. So, at the right time, God sent a tiny baby to be born in the small town of Bethlehem, God's very own son, Jesus. But Jesus didn't stay a little baby. He started to grow.
Which is where our story starts.
Take it away.
Hey, everyone.
Hey, Brian.
Hey, Brian.
As Jesus grew up, he had to learn stuff, just like we do. He had to learn how to walk and talk, how to put on his own sandals, how to grip a stone to toss it in the creek. And as he grew older, Jesus learned how to help his mom with chores and how to fit together smooth boards in his dad's carpentry shop. And every year, Jesus and his family joined other Jewish people traveling the long, dusty road to Jerusalem to celebrate the Passover feast. Now, this trip would have taken at least 4 or 5 days. Think about it. No car, no bus. That was nearly a week walking every day, all day. But it was a special time, too. Jesus was able to run and play with other kids during the trip, and they all camped out under the stars. At last, Jesus and his family reached the city, along with thousands of other people. They likely stayed with family or friends to celebrate for the whole week, and they shared a special meal together on the very last evening. As they ate roast lamb, they remembered and retold the story of how God had rescued them from slavery in Egypt.
Why do we eat this meal every year?
We were slaves in Egypt, and the Lord took us out from there with a strong hand and with an outstretched arm.
The next morning, Jesus' family packed up and joined the crowds flowing back out of Jerusalem. Jesus knew when they were leaving, so his parents expected he would just travel with a group and join them when they stopped to camp as usual. But in the evening, Jesus did not turn up.
Have you seen him this afternoon?
I haven't seen him since we left Jerusalem. I thought he was ahead of us with Eli's family.
Has anyone seen Jesus?
Mary and Joseph hurried through camp, checking with all their friends and family. A sick feeling settled in their stomachs as they began to realize, somehow, Jesus had been left behind in Jerusalem. The trip back to Jerusalem must have seemed endless. Mary and Joseph were already exhausted, and their imaginations were working overtime.
What if he got hurt?
He could have been knocked down by a Roman chariot. Those soldiers don't care who's in their way.
When Mary and Joseph finally reached Jerusalem, again, they searched everywhere for their son.
We already checked with all the cousins.
Maybe he's in the market.
No one had seen Jesus since the day before. Mary and Joseph must have been sick with worry by the third day when they thought to look in one last place.
He loves to study the scriptures. What about the school at the temple?
But that's for scholars and teachers.
Still, Mary and Joseph decided to look just to be certain. Sure enough, when Mary and Joseph hurried into the temple courtyard, they saw a group of teachers.
Joseph, that's Jesus, right in the middle.
They're actually letting him talk.
Now, we don't know exactly what Jesus discussed with the teachers, but they were all amazed at how much he understood and at the wise answers he gave to their questions. As soon as Mary saw Jesus, she rushed to him.
Son, why have you treated us like this? Your father and I have been worried about you. We have been looking for you everywhere.
Why were you looking for me? Didn't you know I had to be in my father's house?
See, Mary and Joseph had been so stressed out that they'd forgotten what the angel told them more than 12 years before, that Jesus is God's son. It made complete sense for Jesus to be in the temple, but Mary and Joseph still didn't fully understand. Jesus returned to Nazareth with his parents. He loved them deeply and obeyed them, and Mary kept everything that had happened in her heart like a secret treasure. As Jesus continued to grow, he became both wiser and stronger, and he found more and more favor with God and the people around him. The end.
I'm pretty sure I'd be grounded for a year if I went missing for 3 days.
Yeah, But Jesus did have a really legit reason to stay behind in the temple.
Well, first and foremost, Jesus is God's son, right? And Jesus knew that listening to God and learning more about God was the very most important thing that he could do.
Even though it was hard to understand for Joseph and Mary.
So, what's our part in the story?
Learning about God can seem like just one more thing to check off. But discovering God is so much more. God is the creator of the entire universe, yet God wants to have a relationship with you. When you read scripture or memorize a verse, God can speak to you through those words.
You can also learn about God when you talk to people who follow God or read things they've written.
You can start small. Pick one verse to read every day for a week.
Or ask an adult to help you choose a devotional book, and that can help you discover so much more.
And here's the awesome thing. The more you learn about God and the more you start to know God, the more you want to discover.
God is so big. There's no end to what you can learn and know about him.
I think you guys have the picture. See you next time.
So here's the thing. Knowing God is the most important thing.
Do you think God can help me find my Rubik's Cube?
I think the eyes God gave you can help you find it.
Where?
Okay, I'll help you. Right now you're cold.
Okay.
Colder? Warm? Warmer? Warmer? Hot! Burning!
Oh, there Woo! It is!
Thanks for joining us in the Story Lab. See you next time.
Okay, so you start like this. First you rotate.